So in the step by step approach, first glance premise a question. There is no best thing in this world except the previous year question. Make them your best friend. You must buy the previous year question combination, which are classified topic wise, and you should have them in a hard copy. Usko hard copy mein rakhna hai. Don't keep that in the soft copy. Please keep in mind. Keep that at your study table, always with you, right? So previous year questions. Second is understanding the basic concept. Foundation building. So welcome everyone, and I want to tell you something. If you are in this session, you have the high commitment. Just being in this session means that you are committed to become the IAS officer, and you are committed to prepare this subject of economy in the best possible manner. And my promise to you is that after this session, you will have a lot of clarity on how to master the economy, right? So let us start. So something about me. My name is CA Rahul Kumar, and I am a graduate of commerce and a chartered accountant. I am the faculty and also one of the director at dadami.com, and we are located in New Delhi. I have appeared 3 times in the IAS interview, and I have a teaching experience of almost 7 years. I am the expert in GS economy and other areas of the prelims and mains areas. About Didami IAS, the commitment of the Didami IAS is to crown you with success and personal attention plus the quality. These two are our USPs. So the entire team Didami IAS is standing for your success. These are our credentials. We have impacted over 30,000 students, over 50 plus toppers, and we have almost 15 plus courses going on. Now, these are the people who have qualified from various programs I have been part of in 2018 and in 2019. These are the recent toppers. In this series of webinars, we are going to cover lot many areas. So the name of this series is Margdarshan. Hum aapko Margdarshan guide karne wale hain in this series of webinars, right? So are you excited? Yes or no? Are you excited to get the guidance through these sessions? And we are going to cover almost every area that is important for your success in this examination. Like today we have the session on the economy, then the day after tomorrow we have the session on current affairs, what will be the strategy for current affairs. So on 2nd October at 5 p.m. we have this session. So log this date, 5 p.m. on 2nd October you are meeting me for the current affairs session. On 6th of October we will see how to score 450 plus marks in the GS mains examination, right? In the mains examination GS portion, how to score 450 plus marks. Then on 8th of October we will discuss about answer writing and enrichment, how to ensure that our efforts are directed to maximize the answer quality. Then on 12th of October the session about essay writing. On 15th of October a special session on international relations. 19th of October the session on NCRT. Then 25th of October the session on how to solve the prelims MCQs. Apart from this, we will be having other sessions like how to master GS paper 2, how to master GS paper 3, like that. So are you excited to attend all these sessions? Say yes if you are excited, and believe me, these are going to be wonderful sessions. Now coming to the business. So in this session I am going to discuss the syllabus of UPSC for the GS economy, the topic wise importance based upon the last 5 years pattern, the why economy seems to be difficult. Is it difficult? Is it really difficult? Say yes or no, and be honest, be straight. There is no right or wrong answer. Okay, great. So some people are saying no, and some people are saying yes. Both of you are valid. Then we will discuss this whole concept of inflation for 5 minutes only, and I will show you if we cover this economy in the conceptual manner, then economy is the most interesting subject. Economy आपका सबसे interesting subject हो सकता है. We will discuss the step-by-step approach to cover the economy, the different type of questions that have been coming, then the concepts of economy, how to cover the current affairs of economy, how to ensure that there is a better practice. Then we will discuss various pitfalls and traps of economy, and this is how we are going to cover this session. Now I will ask from you, are you a fresher or have you already covered the economy? So you can write in the chat box fresher or already, or ALREADY, so that I come to know the target audience, and accordingly I can give you better guidance. Secondly, what are the problems which you have been facing in economy, if you have already covered the economy from anywhere, right? So the issues, if you have something, if you have come up with some query already in your mind, it will always be better to write that query so that I can reply to that query in an individual manner, right? So this session will be having the duration of approximately 60 minutes. We will try to wrap up at around 8 p.m. After that, I will open the forum for open query. You can ask any of your query and I will answer each and every query, right? So let us start. For getting the maximum benefit of this session, I will recommend, first of all, take notes. It is always recommended to take the notes. So if you have the blank paper and pen, that is good. If you don't have, not a problem, but it is recommended. Secondly, bring your 100% attention here, right? This is not a movie, this is a study session. So take it seriously. Don't engage into any other activity. Don't check WhatsApp, Facebook in between the session if you want to take the maximum advantage of the session. Now, starting with the syllabus of economy. What is the syllabus of economy? And by the way, let me tell you, this session is specifically meant for prelims area. This is not meant for mains. So in today's session, we will discuss only about prelims, not about mains examination. Is that okay, clear? So for the mains examination, we are having the session on 6th of October, and we will have a separate session for the GS3 separately, right? So today we will focus only on prelims area. So do you know how much is the weightage of GS economy in the UPSC examination? Any idea? How, like, out of 100 question, how many questions are from the economy? Any idea? You can write in the chat box. Okay, so let me share with you. Between 20 questions to 25 questions. Isn't that great? It means if you master economy, you have mastered almost 1/4 of the prelims area. Isn't it great? And in the mains examination, it is very, very important. In the interview also, it is very, very important, right? So let us start with the syllabus of UPSC. So in the prelims, this is the syllabus. So this is a broad syllabus. The syllabus is not given in detail. The syllabus is given in an indicative manner. So this syllabus is given in indicative manner. It means not in detailed manner, means they have not given the details of the syllabus, right? So what is the indicative syllabus? Sustainable development, poverty, inclusion, demographics, social sector initiatives. But the best way to identify the type of questions which have been asked, and the best way to really see what is the syllabus, we should go back to the previous year questions, right? So if we see the previous year questions, based upon the previous year questions, we can see that there are some predefined concepts in the economy which are there. So the first is the basics of economy, national income and inflation. This is the first important unit. Then we have money and banking. This is the most important unit. Then we have budget, taxation and fiscal sector, right? So this is about the rupee, the flow of money in the economy. This is about the government finances. Then foreign sector, export, import, right? All the transactions, remittances from outside India. Then we have agriculture, industry and services, that is different sectors of the economy. Then we have infrastructure like transport, energy, like road, oil, etc. Then we have social sector, which includes poverty, unemployment, sanitation and so on, right? So these are the major components of the syllabus. And how do we identify this syllabus? Based upon the previous year question, right? So the best way is to see the previous year questions. Now, dimension of the syllabus. Now we have got an idea. In economy, there are two areas. If you have ever read the economy, there are two areas of economy. One is the microeconomy. Microeconomy means basically individual behavior is studied here, right? So focus on the individual behavior. For example, the concept of demand and supply. So in our syllabus, we don't have to read the microeconomy. Yes, in some of the years, this microeconomy may be asked, but only exceptionally and only because it is in current affair, right? So it is not in the syllabus. But macroeconomy, what is macroeconomy? Studying the behavior of economy at the national level, right? National level par padhna usko, right? Or at the mass level. For example, what is the trend of prices at the national level? Or what is the trend of unemployment at the national level? So in UPSC IAS, we are covering only and only macroeconomy, not microeconomy. Is that clear? Great. Now, static or current? The answer is both. Static, in the static we have to cover the concept, and in the current affairs we have to cover the recent trends, the facts, the government initiatives, various reports, etc. Right? So both current affairs and static, both are important. Both are equally important. We cannot ignore any of these area. Theory or application, which is more important? The answer is both. Both are very, very important, right? So we should know the meaning of CRR, that is the cash reserve ratio, and we should know what is the implication of cash reserve ratio, how that is used and how that has been used in the recent few years, right? So both theory and application are important. Now, 5 years pattern, let us review the last 5 years. So based upon the last 5 years pattern, we can see that these are the five important areas. In fact, the four important areas. If you cover these four important areas, then most of your syllabus is done, right? So what are these areas? These include the banking sector, the government sector, that is the fiscal policy, taxation and subsidies. Then the external sector, that is the foreign sector, export, import ki jahan baat karte hain, relevant government schemes. So this is also very, very important nowadays, right? So basically banking, government, foreign sector and government scheme, these are the four very, very important area. If you are mastering this area, let me tell you, you have got almost 80% of the economy done. If you see 2019 paper, you can see 6 plus 1 plus 5 plus 2. How many? 7, 5. 14 questions have come from this only 4 topic. 14 question, it means a lot. Single chapter is giving you 6 marks, 6 questions. Second chapter, extra chapter is giving you 10 marks. That is the 5 questions, right? So, very, very important area. Then there are other areas which are not that much important, like population, agriculture, planning, industrial policy, but we have to cover them because we never know UPSC can ask any question at any point of time, right? So now My question is, why economy seems to be difficult? So would you like to answer this question? Why economy is difficult for you? Why you feel that economy is not my cup of tea? Okay, Shashwati, I will explain the meaning of train, don't worry. And I will also discuss how to cover NCERT, right? So you can type your question. Okay, understanding levels, okay. Because it has vast syllabus, okay, I got it. Wonderful. Deepshika is saying it is easy. Very good, wonderful. So now let us see. First of all, that many people, they rarely study IAS this economy before the preparation of IAS examination. In your school time, in your graduation, you never touch economy. This is the first reason. Then, unfortunately, there is not a single book which gives you the comprehensive coverage of the economy. So we have, suppose we have polity. In polity, there is a very famous book, Lakshmikant. But can you name a single book in economy? There are many books, but if you read one book, you will not be able to cover everything. So that is the problem. Then, this is very, very dynamic in nature, right? This is very, very dynamic in nature. Means, what is happening recently? The protest against the agricultural bill. So those agricultural bills or ordinances came just this month only, in the 7th of September only. So we have to be aware about what is happening in the country every day. RBI is bringing many initiative, government is bringing many initiative. Almost every day you will find very important news about the economy. Then it is very difficult to define the boundaries of economy, because you see government scheme, international relation, you see various reports, I mean everything you can cover in the economy, right? Everything you can cover in the economy. It is a very vast syllabus and not a single book. That is why the preparation becomes so complex. Otherwise economy difficult nahi hai. Maine aapko bataya, sirf 4 chapter kar lijiye, right? Sirf 4 chapter kar lijiye. Banking, public finance, government scheme and foreign sector. Aapka 80% economy ho gaya. Aapka 80% economy ho gaya, right? So which chapter? Can you name the chapter? Banking, public finance, the foreign sector and the government scheme, right? Aapka 80% economy ho gaya. Now, let me share with you very small concept, and through this you can understand that economy is not difficult. So this is basically the concept of inflation, and this is considered to be very conceptual topic. And I have taken this topic because many of you are already aware about this topic, and we will discuss this concept and solve the previous year question of the UPSC. Then you can understand that if you are conceptually clear, if you are thinking in a logical manner, then economy becomes very, very easy, right? So are you excited to learn this concept? Say yes in the chat box if you are excited. So basically, what is inflation? Inflation matlab mehngai. Mehngai. Rise in the price. Price badhna. Aur kisi ko bhi achha nahi lagta. So basically, if we see inflation, it is very clear to everyone, right? Not a big deal. But when we are covering in the civil service examination, if we follow some standard definition from the government sources, it is always better, right? So for example, this is the definition given by Economic Survey of 2008-09, that the inflation is an upward movement, means the price is rising, upward movement. In general prices, general means it is not limited to any single commodity. It is in general throughout the country. It is not limited to Delhi, Mumbai, Kolkata, Chennai or Lucknow, Kanpur. No, it is throughout the country. It is general, right? And it can be in goods, it can be in services or it can mean both, right? So this is the meaning of inflation or mehngai. In simple word, can we say that a general rise in the prices. Simple. General rise in the prices. This is inflation. Now, there are two more conditions that it should be persistent. Persistent means over a period of time, there should be a trend. It is not that if in 1 week it is increasing, second week it is decreasing, 1 week it is increasing. So it is not persistent. Then it is not inflation. Right? It should be appreciable. Appreciable means it should be clearly visible. If, for example, we talk about the prices of sugar. So if the prices of sugar rise just by, 50 paisa, it is not a appreciable rise. Right? So appreciable means it should be clearly visible. Everyone should feel it. Then it is part of the inflation. Right? Now, this is calculated on year to year basis. What is the meaning of year on year basis? Year on year basis means, for example, we are talking about the inflation of sugar. So if we are calculating the inflation of sugar for the month of September 2020, then we will cover how much was the price of sugar in September 2019. So for example, if the price of sugar in September 2019 was 50 rupees and this year this is 55 rupees, then there is a 10% increase in the price. This 10% is the rate of inflation. So year on year means comparing the same period of the last year, right? So comparing September 2019 price with the September 2020 price, if we compare, there is a rise of 10%. So this rise is called year on year calculation of inflation. Then we have that this inflation reduces the purchasing power of money. Money ki purchasing power kam kar deta hai. Kaise kam karta hai? So, for example, we talk about this sugar only. So, this sugar, suppose in 2019, there is Mr. A. And Mr. A spends total amount of 1000 rupees on the sugar. The price of sugar is suppose 20 rupees per kg. So how much quantity he can buy? He can buy 50 kg. So this is about 2019. In 2019, in 1000 rupees, he can buy how much? 50 kg. Suppose in 2020, the price increases to 25 rupees per kg. Now, in the same amount of rupee, that is 1000 rupees, how much he can buy? He can buy how much? 40 kg. So, the purchasing power of 1000 rupees was 50 kg in 2019. In 2020, the purchasing power of this 1000 rupees is only 40 kg. That means because of increase in the price of sugar, because of inflation from 20 rupees to 25 rupees, there is reduction in the purchasing power of the money. Is that clear to everyone? Say yes or no. So this is called reducing the purchasing power of money because of inflation. Right? Now, what are the causes of inflation? Inflation kyun hota hai? Dekhiye, inflation ka matlab rise in the price. Now, rise in the price means, so rise in the price can be either because the demand is high, ya to demand jyada hai, ya supply kam hai, right? So, either demand is more or supply is less. Or third reason can be that the cost is high. Cost is increasing. Cost of input is increasing. These are the three possible reasons because of which the prices can rise. Now, first one, this is the increase in demand. दिस इज कॉल्ड डिमांड पुल इन्फ्लेशन. इसको हम बोलते हैं डिमांड इन्फ्लेशन, यानी कि डिमांड की वजह से जो इन्फ्लेशन हुआ है. डिक्रीज इन सप्लाई, दैट मींस सप्लाई लेड इन्फ्लेशन, सप्लाई कम होने की वजह से जो इन्फ्लेशन हुआ है. एंड देन थर्ड वी हैव कॉस्ट पुश इन्फ्लेशन, दैट इज बिकॉज ऑफ इंक्रीज इन द इनपुट प्राइसेस, इनपुट में जो प्राइसेस की वजह से इंक्रीज हुआ है, राइट. सो फॉर एग्जांपल इफ यू टॉक अबाउट यू नो शुगर, सो इन द शुगर, चीनी के अंदर शुगर केन, गन्ना, शुगर केन इज द इनपुट. सो इफ द प्राइस ऑफ द शुगर केन इंक्रीज, देन इट इज वेरी नेचुरल दैट द प्राइस ऑफ द शुगर विल ऑल्सो इंक्रीज, राइट. सो डिमांड पुल, सप्लाई लेड एंड द कॉस्ट पुश इन्फ्लेशन. नाउ डिमांड पुल, डिमांड पुल, डिमांड क्यों बढ़ सकती है? डोंट सी दिस, जस्ट थिंक कि डिमांड क्यों बढ़ सकती है. सो डिमांड, आप यू विल डिमांड एनीथिंग इफ आइदर यू हैव मोर अमाउंट ऑफ मनी इन योर पॉकेट, या तो आपके पॉकेट में ज्यादा पैसा आ जाए, राइट, और देयर इज सम अदर रीजन, आपकी फैमिली में ज्यादा मेंबर हो जाए, राइट. अगर आप अपनी फैमिली की बात करो, या तो आपकी फैमिली में पैसे ज्यादा आ जाए, मनी ज्यादा आ जाए आपकी जेब में, या आपके फैमिली के मेंबर बढ़ जाए, नया मेंबर आ जाए, तो डिमांड बढ़ जाती है. सिमिलरली इन द कंट्री ऑल्सो डिमांड पुल इन्फ्लेशन कैन हैपन आइदर बिकॉज ऑफ इंक्रीज इन मनी सप्लाई और बिकॉज ऑफ इंक्रीज इन द पॉपुलेशन ग्रोथ, राइट. सो नाउ पैसा कहां से आ सकता है? हाउ इंक्रीज इन मनी सप्लाई इज पॉसिबल? इंक्रीज इन मनी सप्लाई इज पॉसिबल बिकॉज ऑफ वेरियस रीजंस. सो व्हाट आर दीज रीजंस? वन रीजन कैन बी इंक्रीज इन द पर्सनल इनकम ग्रोथ. सैलरी से इनकम बढ़ गई है, सैलरी ऑफ द पर्सन हैज इंक्रीज्ड, सो फैमिली इनकम इज इंक्रीजिंग, राइट. सेकंड, द गवर्नमेंट एक्सपेंडिचर. सो बेसिकली वी आर टॉकिंग एट द नेशनल लेवल, हम नेशनल लेवल की बात कर रहे हैं, वी आर इन द मैक्रो इकोनॉमी, राइट. सो एट द मैक्रो इकोनॉमिक लेवल द गवर्नमेंट इज स्पेंडिंग मोर अमाउंट. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इट इज गिविंग मोर अमाउंट टू द फार्मर, राइट. फार्मर को पैसा देता है, सो व्हेन फार्मर गेट द मनी देन इट इंक्रीज द डिमांड. Then decrease in the rate of interest on the loan given by bank. So suppose earlier the bank was given the loan at the rate of 10% interest. Now they are giving the loan at the rate of 9%. Then normally those people who could not afford it earlier, जो लोग पहले नहीं कर सकते थे इसको afford, अब वो loan ले सकते हैं, right? So अगर interest का rate कम होता है, if the rate of interest is decreasing, then also the money supply can increase. Money supply increase हो सकती है. Then foreign capital can come into India. FDI जिसको बोलते हैं, foreign investment, foreign direct investment, FPI, foreign portfolio investment, right? So foreign investment can come into India. Because of that, the money supply can increase. Then high income from the export. So for example, in the COVID time, our pharmaceutical export increased. हमारे जो pharma का जो एक्सपोर्ट था वो बढ़ गया था. सो बिकॉज ऑफ दैट वी स्टार्टेड रिसीविंग मोर मनी. एंड नेक्स्ट कैन बी हाई ब्लैक मनी. ब्लैक मनी भी आपकी हो सकती है बिकॉज ऑफ द ब्लैक मनी. व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ ब्लैक मनी? दैट मनी ऑन विच द टैक्स इज नॉट पेड बाय द पर्सन, राइट. अगर टैक्स पे नहीं होता है तो उसको ब्लैक मनी बोलते हैं. सो इफ देर इज हाई अमाउंट ऑफ ब्लैक मनी, देन ऑल्सो द डिमांड कैन इंक्रीज. तो भी डिमांड आपकी इंक्रीज हो सकती है, राइट. सो these are various factors because of which the money supply is increasing, and if money supply increases then demand increases. Second factor for demand can be high population growth. Hamara population growth to वैसे ही बहुत ज्यादा है, we are the very fast growing country in terms of population. Or it can be because of change in the taste and preferences. So for example, now we are demanding more nutritious products, right. So you will see the prices of nutritious products are increasing, organic products are increasing. So those products which are in demand because of change in the taste and preferences, their prices also rise. Is that clear everyone? Are you getting it? Okay, great, wonderful. Now what is the second area because of which the prices can rise? So prices can rise because of supply shortage. Supply कम हो जाती है. Now the supply can decrease because of any reason. The one reason can be shortage of factors of production. For example, in the COVID lockdown situation, the labor migrated to their hometown. Labor migration started to their hometown. So in the city areas, the factor of production, it was reduced. What is the meaning of factor of production? Means those factors which are important for production. So it can be labor, it can be raw material, it can be land, it can be a businessman, right? So agar unki shortage ho jati hai to supply kam ho jayegi, right? Industrial disputes, for example strike hoti hai, tab bhi aapka supply kam ho sakta hai, right? That it is quite possible. Natural calamities, for example there is floods aa gayi hai, because of floods there is destruction of the crops, agriculture has badly impacted, so this can also lead to decrease in the supply. Artificial scarcity because of the hoarding or black marketing, the stockers, they are stocking the goods in their godown so that they can sell when the prices rise. Then increase in the export, if the exports of any commodity is increasing then supply will decrease inside the country. हम कहां की बात कर रहे हैं, वी आर टॉकिंग इनसाइड द कंट्री. सो इनसाइड द कंट्री द डिमांड द सप्लाई विल रिड्यूस. एंड देन इंटरनेशनल फैक्टर्स फॉर एग्जांपल देयर इज सम प्रॉब्लम विद द मिडिल ईस्ट कंट्रीज, सो ऑयल सप्लाई विल गो डाउन. इफ द ऑयल सप्लाई गोज डाउन देन ऑल्सो इंपैक्ट द प्राइसेस, राइट? सो इट कैन बी बिकॉज ऑफ इंटरनेशनल फैक्टर्स. नाउ कॉस्ट पुश इन्फ्लेशन इंक्रीज इन द कॉस्ट ऑफ इनपुट. कॉस्ट ऑफ इनपुट बढ़ जाता है. व्हाई दिस कॉस्ट ऑफ इनपुट इंक्रीजेस? फॉर एग्जांपल इन द एग्रीकल्चर एरिया देयर इज अ बैड मानसून सम ईयर, एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दिस बैड मानसून देयर इज लेस क्रॉप प्रोडक्शन, एंड बिकॉज ऑफ द लेस क्रॉप प्रोडक्शन द प्राइसेज ऑफ द रॉ मटेरियल फॉर द इंडस्ट्री आर इंक्रीजिंग. सो इट लीड्स टू राइजिंग कॉस्ट ऑफ इनपुट. अगर राइजिंग कॉस्ट ऑफ इनपुट होगी तो डेफिनेटली the prices will increase, right? So are you clear? Three factors of rise in production, rise in prices. The demand pull can be because of two factors. Either it can be because of increase in the money supply or it can be because of the population growth rate, right? Then second is supply shortage can be because of different factors. And third is the cost push inflation, the increase in the cost of input, right? So are you clear? The three factors of increase in the prices. Now so increase in demand, decrease in supply, or cost push inflation, these are the three categories of inflation based upon the factors of production, based upon the causes of inflation. Now UPSC previous year question. So are you ready for the UPSC previous year question? So whatever query you have, you can ask and I will answer at the end, not right now, because I will give you separate time, right? Don't worry. Okay, great. So I can see most of you are really excited to solve the UPSC previous year question. So this is the question in front of your screen. Let us see. So please read this question carefully. Take your time. And you have how much time? You have 1 minute. Your time starts now. You have 1 minute and please think what is the right answer. So please. Okay, so I can see many people are joining through the YouTube also. So welcome everyone, and you can ask your queries in the YouTube also, and I'll answer at the end, right? So I'll answer at the end. Okay, great. So I can see a lot of answers on the screen. I really feel so happy to see the answers. And don't worry about the right or wrong answer, just give the answer. Okay, so please keep giving the answer. I am still waiting for more answer. I want that everyone should give the answer so that you feel more engaged. I want this session to be interactive. Okay, great. So let us see the question. The question is a rise in the general level of prices. So I have already told you the definition, right? So this is nothing but the inflation. Inflation may be caused by, number one, an increase in the money supply.
Yes,
money supply increase, that means demand increases. If demand increases, then prices increases. That means there is inflation.
Correct.
Second, a decrease in the aggregate level of output, means the total production has come down. If the total production has come down, that means supply has come down. If supply has come down, then there will be inflation. So statement 1 is correct, statement 2 is correct. Statement 3, an increase in the effective demand. Demand badh gayi hai. Overall demand badh gayi hai. It can be because of money, it can be because of population or any other reason, does not matter. But clearly mentioned that there is an increase in the effective demand. So statement 3 is also correct. Now read the question carefully. Select the correct answer. We have to select the correct answer. So the answer is option D, statement 1, 2 and 3. So congratulations those people who have given the right answer, and congratulations those people who have attempted the question. It means a lot that you attempted the question. So the answer is option D, and this is the question of 2013 UPSC, right? So you have solved the question of 2013 UPSC. Can you see, this is one of the very conceptual question. It is not an easy question, let me tell you. If you have done the mistake, don't worry, right? Don't worry. This is one of the very difficult question. I intentionally pick up the difficult question so that you can see this is the maximum level of difficulty the UPSC can go, and still many people can solve, right? And many people can solve. If you see this session maybe again, then you can understand clearly, because my speed is comparatively faster in this session, because this is a webinar, this is not a regular class. In the regular class, my speed is comparatively slow so that I can explain each and every concept very clearly. So the point is, in this class, my purpose was to show you that economy is not difficult. Economy is not difficult if you understand it conceptually, if you understand this systematically, right? Is that clear, everyone? Now, what should be the approach? Ab hum baat karte hain ki approach kya hona chahiye. Abhi tak hum logon ne baat kiya syllabus, important chapters, kya hona chahiye. Then we discussed the previous question also. Now, step by step approach to cover the economy, right? So in the step by step approach, first glance previous year question. There is no best thing in this world except the previous year question. Make them your best friend. You must buy the previous year question compilation, which are classified topic wise, and you should have them in a hard copy. Usko hard copy mein rakhna hai. Don't keep that in the soft copy. Please keep in mind, keep that at your study table, always with you, right? So previous year questions. Second is understanding the basic concept, foundation build karna hai. I will discuss each and every area, how to like analyze the previous year question, how to build the foundation. I will discuss each and every area. Don't worry, I am here, right? So next 20 minutes, I will discuss everything. Revision is very, very important. Daily revision, weekly revision, monthly revision, and before the examination, right? Every moment it has to be there. Then MCQ practice and previous year question practice. So five step approach, previous year question, concept, foundation, then concept and current affairs, revision and the MCQ practice. This five step approach will make you the master in the economy. Now, concepts. So we are coming to the previous year questions, right? So in the previous year question, there are different type of questions. What are the different categories of questions? The first is conceptual question. Jaisa hum logon ne pehle dekh chuke hain. Inflation cost question, which I discussed, that was the question of concept. Data and facts. The questions which ask you about some data, they ask you about some trend. And we will see the example of every type of question, right? Then we have the questions based upon the government scheme. Then we have the questions based upon the various national, international organizations. Then we have the questions based upon the reports and rankings, right? So first of all, the questions based upon the concept. One, we have already seen the UPSC question of inflation 2013. This is another question, capital adequacy ratio. So this is the conceptual question. I will not discuss the question because here just my purpose is just to make you familiar with the previous question pattern, not to discuss the syllabus, right? data and facts. So this question is about data and facts. For example, you can see most of the India's external loan, that means loan, is owed by government entities, right? Second is all of the India's external debt is denominated in the US dollar. So they are not asking, वो ये नहीं पूछ रहे हैं कि कितना loan है या कितना government entity ने लिया हुआ है. They are asking the trend. Most means majority, more than 50%. All means 100%, right? So they are asking the trend. They are not asking the quantity. So you don't have to remember how much is the loan, किसने कितना लिया हुआ है, कौन सी currency में कितना है. आपको सिर्फ पता होना चाहिए ट्रेंड, बिकॉज दिस एग्जामिनेशन इज IAS एग्जामिनेशन, दिस इज नॉट ए क्लेरिकल एग्जामिनेशन. इज दैट क्लियर व्हाट आई मीन बाय द डाटा एंड फैक्ट्स? सो डाटा एंड फैक्ट्स डज नॉट मीन दैट वी हैव टू रिमेंबर ईच एंड एवरी पॉइंट. नाउ अनदर क्वेश्चन इज गवर्नमेंट स्कीम्स. द गवर्नमेंट स्कीम फॉर एग्जाम्पल फूड सिक्योरिटी एक्ट के ऊपर क्वेश्चन है. दे आर आस्किंग अबाउट द डिफरेंट कैटेगरीज, दे आर आस्किंग अबाउट द एलिजिबिलिटी इन टर्म्स ऑफ ईयर, दे आर आस्किंग अबाउट the pregnant women and the lactating mother, and they are giving the statement. So you must know the features of the government schemes also, right? Then they can ask about the international organizations. For example, Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank, ki how many members are there, whether India is the member or not, and if yes, then is it the largest member or not, and like that. So membership of the organization is very important area. The presence of the organization, the jurisdiction, the purpose, like that. Then we have national organizations. For example, Petroleum and Natural Gas Regulatory Board, right? So the task of this board and what happens if there is a dispute against the decision of this board. So this kind of question can be there. And then the questions on the report, Global Competitiveness Report, right? And various other report, Gender Gap Report, then Transparency International Report. There are not many report others, right? WTO, World Bank, IMF, all of them are giving the reports. Are you clear? So we have seen the previous year questions. The previous year questions can be conceptual, factual, national organization, international organization, government scheme, write that. Now, how to build the foundation? So building the foundation, for that, first of all, you must go through the NCERT. And I will suggest you go through the NCERT of 12th class, that is the introductory macroeconomy. Don't go through this NCERT, that is not required. Microeconomy is not required because only macroeconomy is in the syllabus, not the microeconomy. Then we have this 11th class NCERT, that is the Indian Economic Development. This NCERT is very, very important. It is about India. Ye India ke baare mein hai. Indian economy ke baare mein hai ye, right? Planning, agriculture, infrastructure, industry. Then this is about the concept. Ye concept ke baare mein hai. The concept of government, budget, concept of banking, concept of, you know, poverty, unemployment, like that. So these two NCERT are very, very important. So in this session, I am giving you a task. Are you ready? Are you interested? I always try to give the homework in my sessions so that you have something to take out after the session. So my invitation is download this NCERT from our website. If you don't have this, agar aapke paas mein nahi hai, I will show you how to download. I will show you a website also. So go to the website, download it, read the first chapter, and you have to complete that before sleeping today, right? So are you accepting this challenge? I am challenging. I am giving you a challenge. Are you accepting this challenge of downloading the NCERT and completing one chapter before you sleep today, right? How many of you are taking this challenge? Okay, great. I can see large number of people taking this challenge. Very good. Wonderful. That shows the commitment that you have. Wonderful. Okay. Continue. I can see. Wonderful. So now how to cover the NCERT? Ab cover kaise karni hai sir? Theek hai, very good important question. So for covering the NCERT, in the first reading cover this as a novel. Ek novel ki tarah padhna hai, ज्यादा दिमाग नहीं लगाना, अंडरस्टैंड दिस राइट, कवर दिस एज ए नॉवल. सेकेंड रीडिंग अंडरलाइन द कीवर्ड्स, एंड थर्ड रीडिंग सॉल्व द क्वेश्चंस गिवन एट द एंड प्लस राइट द कीवर्ड्स इन ए सेपरेट पेपर. That is not making. उसको हम बोलते हैं not बनाना. ठीक है, तो पहले पढ़ना है, second में underline करना है, third में solve the questions and write the keyword in a separate paper. This is how you should read the NCERT. And after that you can discard this NCERT. उसके बाद में आप इस NCERT को भूल जाइए, बार बार पढ़ने की जरूरत नहीं है. You just open your notes, revise from there. So this is how you should read the NCERT. What is other thing you can do? You can go through the standard books. I don't need to tell the name of the standard books. There are a lot of standard books. But the problems with the standard books is that any single standard book is not sufficient. That is the biggest problem. That is why we have formulated a very wonderful notes at Didami. And those notes are available if you join some of the course, like course of economy or prelims cum mains course. And we have included everything that is important for this examination. I will share the sample notes, I will send it on email to you, right, the notes of the inflation chapter, and like we have covered everything, like NCERT, the standard books, we have covered the current affairs, the previous year questions, and the practice questions, economic survey, budget, everything, right. So you can do, you can go through that, right. Now, so we have seen the previous year question, we have seen how to build the foundation. The third is करंट अफेयर्स. करंट अफेयर्स सर कहां से कवर करना है, राइट. सो देयर आर सो मेनी सोर्सेस. वी हैव द हिंदू, इंडियन एक्सप्रेस, इकोनॉमिक सर्वे, बजट, इंडिया ईयरबुक, योजना, कुरुक्षेत्र. टोटल हाउ मेनी सोर्सेस? सेवन सोर्सेस. बट सर हाउ टू कवर? दैट इज द बिगेस्ट क्वेश्चन. हाउ टू मास्टर दिस? दैट इज द बिगेस्ट क्वेश्चन, राइट. सो बेसिकली द सिंपल फंडा इज वंस यू गो थ्रू द एनसीईआरटी एंड वंस यू आर थ्रो विद द बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट, whenever you are reading the daily news, try to interlink with the concept. For example, if there is a news about monetary policy, open your notes and try to link with that. Understand in systematic manner. Don't try to isolate the static and the current affairs portion. That is the best way, right? Reading the monthly magazine, still you try to master the basic concept. If you talk about the Hindu versus Indian Express, you can follow any one newspaper, not a problem. Any newspaper is good newspaper. No need to follow the both newspaper. And we are providing daily current affairs. And from 1st of October, wonderful quality current affairs are going to come on the website and the Telegram channel. How many of you are not on the Telegram channel? So I will share the link of the Telegram channel so that you can join. And the Telegram channel is wonderful. We are providing lot many things out of all of the updates. At daily 10 a.m. I will be coming in the live session. You can ask me any question. So the name of the initiative is Ask Me Anything, right? So daily 10 a.m. you can ask me anything about anything. Means that is not about the technical thing, but about your preparation, the strategy, what should be the best strategy, right? So Ask Me Anything initiative, daily 10 a.m. I'm continuing this session, this initiative, where you can ask any question, and those questions, those sessions will be the live session. So let me share with you the link of the Telegram. So this is the link, okay, you can join. And from 1st of October, from tomorrow onwards, we will give wonderful current affairs, right, wonderful. Now Hindu Express, then is economic survey. Economic survey, in the economic survey there are two volume, volume 1, volume 2. In the volume 1 it is about mains examination, not for the prelims examination. Volume 2 is about prelims examination, and in the volume 2 only first 5 important chapters are there. If you just cover the first 5 chapters, that is more than sufficient, right. And don't worry, I will send you the email of this PPT, right, so that you can revise this PPT, you can follow this PPT, you can refer to this PPT, right. I will send you the copy of this PPT on the email ID, and we will put on the Telegram channel also, don't worry, right. Now budget, and by the way, we have given the summary of this economic survey, budget, free of cost on our website, and let me show you so that those people who want to download these resources from the website, they can go through the website. And in the website you can see this NCRT download. So in the NCRT download, you can download the NCRT of the economy. You can see these NCRT 12th 12th and 11th. In fact, you can even go through the 9th and 10th NCRT if you are 100% new, right? So that you can get the basic idea about few things. Then if you go to the free resources only, then you have this free downloads. In the free downloads, you can see this budget crux, economic survey volume 1, economic survey volume 2, right? All of them are there. And then we have given other sources, and here only we will upload the PPT of this session also. You can download directly from this. So we will upload by tonight, right? Or by tomorrow morning, right? So you can download from here. So now coming back. Now, budget. Budget is already covered up, and in the budget you have to just cover the important schemes that have been, you know, introduced last recently. Then India yearbook, this is important for the government schemes. Only government scheme you should cover from here. Yojana and Krukshetra. Yojana and Krukshetra, not everything. For the prelims only, there are few pages. So in few pages they just give the important government initiatives. You just read the government scheme more carefully, because those topics are asked in the examination, right? So this is how we should cover the current affairs. So I'm just revising it again. Hindu, Indian Express, you follow one newspaper and try to interlink the concept with the current affair. Don't read in isolation. Economic survey volume 2, chapter number 1 to 5. Budget, only the government scheme. India yearbook, the government scheme. Yojana and Kukshetra, only the government scheme, which have been given on some of the important pages in the form of advertisement, right? No need to follow the articles, and so those things will be covered in the mains examination, and I will tell you separately for that, right? But for the prelims, only that much is required. Now, for value addition, you can take care of some of the statistics and data which is coming in the newspapers. So you can make a separate notebook and keep noting down the important statistics, right? Maybe you will be able to use in the mains examination, and maybe they will be a question in the prelims examination itself. Then we have various committee reports, right? So a lot of committees are there. For example, in the banking sector, Urjit Patel committee, Nachiket Mohr committee, and there is Vimal Jalan committee, and so many other committees in the infrastructure sector, industrial sector, all the sectors. So write the name of the committee, what is the recommendation, what is the area, right? So those reports will automatically become part of the current affairs only. No need to follow any other source for that. Then Niti Aayog, this is a very important source. So in the Niti Aayog, there is a 7-year strategy. In this 7-year strategy document, they have given very good important facts. So you can use those facts in the mains examination, or they can be utilized in the prelims examination also. In our notes of the classes, we have covered all these areas very carefully. Then economic survey, I have already told you about it. Budget, I have already told you. Yojana, I have already told you. Now coming to the other areas, practical examples, the government schemes, acts, bills and bodies, right? Diagrams, so diagram and mind map. So for example, this topic of inflation, we can make the diagrams to make it more clear that there are three type of factors: the demand pull, the supply pull, supply shortage, and the cost push. And then make the mind map. Take a single paper, in the single paper, in the horizontal manner, in the landscape manner, try to cover the entire topic in a single page, right? So that can give you very good notes for the revision time. Now coming to the India yearbook, this is a list of chapters we should cover from the India yearbook. You can go through this chapter list later on when we share the PPT with you. How to practice the MCQ, this is very, very important. So start with the NCERT. First of all, you should follow the MCQ of the NCERT, then the topic wise conceptual MCQ. So pick every topic, banking, inflation, so on. Try to solve at least 100 MCQ on every topic, so that you become the master of every topic. In third phase, you follow the UPSC previous year question topics, the MCQs basically, right? Then you should practice the current affair based MCQ. And finally, you should attempt the full length test. So you must follow only and only this way of practicing the MCQ. NCERT, topic wise, previous year question, current affairs questions, and then full length mock test. And after that, there will be no problem in attending any question. And we will be having a separate session on 25th of October about how to solve the MCQs of the UPSC. Now, there are some pitfalls and traps which you should avoid. What are those pitfalls and traps? Number one, irrelevant data and facts. Never cover those. For example, what is the Sensex level? How much is the investment of some foreign company into the Indian company, right? Walmart into Flipkart. No need to cover those business things. Irrelevant concept, not required, right? So there are a lot of business concepts which are not required. If you see the previous question has a pattern. Follow that pattern only. So many free videos are available. This is a basically biggest problem, right? So follow single teacher if you find it good. Otherwise, it will waste your time. Don't try to follow too much free videos, because they are not covering the entire syllabus in a single video, right? They are just putting few videos to like kind of demo. So don't try to follow the free videos unless you found it of very good quality, right? If you try to cover more and more number of books, notes or videos, then you become complex in your concept. You forget everything. You actually get confused. Agar aap same cheez ko 10 jagah se padhoge to confusion zyada badhega. If you are weak in some area, then you can cover that area maybe from one or two sources, but not every area. It is not that every area will be weak for you. Then reading business newspaper. Some people will say, sir, I am reading Business Standard, Economic Times. Not required. Kabhi zarurat nahi hai aapko karne ki. Don't make your preparation complex. It is a simple examination. It is not a complex examination. Theek hai? It is not a complex examination. Some do's, have patience. You cannot master anything from day one. So revise the books again, practice the MCQ again, refer to the previous year question again. You cannot become the master in a single day. So never lose the patience. Don't doubt yourself. Practice MCQ test simultaneously if possible. Revise regularly and link concept with the current affairs. You must do that. In the focus area, you can follow the national income, economic development, money and banking, public finance, external sector. I have already told you the areas which are important. So we have covered so far prelim syllabus, topic wise importance. We have covered why economy is difficult. We discussed the meaning and causes of inflation, step by approach. So these are accomplishment of this session so far. Now, what are the issues faced by you? You can type in the chat box. And meanwhile, let me share with you some of the important things which we are giving at Didami. So we are giving complete GS economic course, and this course is available at a very with the best quality possible. So let me share with you. So are you excited to know about it? So you go to the website and here courses, and here you will find this course. And in this course we have covered everything. Like, you will be having live interactive sessions. So the sessions like this session is going on, we will be having this kind of sessions only, and they will be recording. You can watch this recording unlimited time, right? Unlimited time you can watch this recording till your examination. And then soft copy study material in the PDF format will be available, exam time synopsis and the mind map. Then we will be giving you the practice questions, around 1000 practice questions. All the previous year questions will be analyzed. Additional sessions will be held for clearing doubt and the weekend. So we will be basically focusing on the concept building in a very systematic manner. We will be covering all the NCERT, all the standard books, current affairs of last 2 years, economic survey, budget, then 1000 plus prelims concept. And then with the duration of the class will be approximately 80 hours, 2 hour session of like 40 sessions. And if you have any doubt, this is our contact number given here. You can drop an email at contact@didami, right? And all these things have been given. Some sessions have been given here. You can use these sessions to strengthen your concept. You can follow these sessions from here. Now, coming back to the one course that we have for the complete prelims cum mains 2021. this course is, you know, wonderful course. Again, this is online, you know, it is catering to prelims, mains, interview, basic concept, starting with the NCERT, and the topic wise lectures will be there, exam oriented lectures, weekly test. So as I told you, first you should cover the NCERT, then you should cover topic wise, then UPSC question, then current affair, then mock. So in this pattern only we will be covering each and every topic, each and every area, geography, environment. So there will be separate faculty for that. We have a complete team of faculty. Then complete coverage of current affairs of last 2 years. Every Saturday and Sunday there will be current affairs session of 2 hours each, and we will be covering the current affair in a very systematic manner. Subject wise detailed notes, you don't need to follow any other source. If you follow these notes, there will be separate sessions by the toppers of, you know, our organization. Then doubt clearing sessions, live doubt clearing session every Saturday, right? So you can know more about this course on the website. So these are our USPs. Then we are providing live interactive classes, doubt clearing sessions, quality notes, assessment test, access anytime, anywhere. What are extra advantages with Didami? We are focusing our batches to be on the weekend. So important things, test, current affairs, doubt clearing sessions are happening on the weekend. So if you have some commitment in the weekday, not a problem. You can still manage the course very well. Doubt clearing sessions, personal tracking. So we will be sharing the Google sheet, and one of the faculty member will be, you know, managing your performance. So that personal tracking will be there, right? And then exam oriented, our session will be completely exam oriented, no intellectualism, no irrelevant discussion. Our team is completely dynamic, and we'll be covering all the possible sources for the current affairs, everything, right? And test for NCERT, previous year question, comprehensive test, subject wise test, current affair test, CSET, every area will be covered very systematically and comprehensively. Then revision tools, this is our also very unique area, unique thing which we provide. So exam time synopsis, 100 words for every topic, then revision clips, 5-minute complete revision, and unlimited number of views. There is no restriction on the number of views you can have for the classes, right? So if you have any problem, revise. This is the weekly schedule. So we have prelims classes in the morning, mains classes in the evening, doubt clearing sessions in the weekend, Saturday, assessment test at the on the Sunday, daily important news we will be giving, daily current affairs summary we will be giving on your email ID. You will be getting daily emails of the current affairs, and daily MCQs also. Answer writing will be done after a certain level, and regular support session, motivation session, and daily class test. At the end of every class, there will be 10 questions which will be discussed and solved by you and with the help of faculty. So this is the plan of every month. So we will start with economy and science and technology, and in the mains area we will discuss international relations, essay, etc. There are other faculties which will be covering those areas, and we have given this complete plan on the website. This is the team of faculties, and there are many other faculties which will be covering the different subjects. And then this product is available on this particular page, complete details. These are the students' reviews, these are the students who have been part of our programs. And then we are also having the scholarship test. We already conducted the scholarship test on last 2 weeks, on the 27th of September. And those people who will appeared, they must be getting the email about that, about the result, everything. And we are having again on the 4th of October, but this time the scholarship test, the scholarships will be limited to the 10% only, right? So till now we were providing the 100% scholarship, till now this will be limited to 10%. So GS based questions will be there, discounts up to 10%. So this is the 10%. Then 100 MCQs will be there, 4th October, 4 PM, right? And we have a session on the best strategy for the UPSC on 4th of October, 1 PM, right? So if you have already attended this session on the last week, you can invite your friends, you can invite your colleagues, family members, or your whosoever is interested in these sessions, right? Any question you have about any course, you can call on this number. You can drop an email at the contact@diademy.com, right? And then we are already coming up with all these webinars. I already told you about these webinars. So next webinar is on current affairs on 2nd of October, right? 2nd of October, current affairs. What is the time? 5 p.m. So 5 p.m. is the time, and we will be making the Zoom link. You can join through that link. We will discuss everything about current affairs, how to master the current affairs. And then we have GS Mains booster session, that is how to increase the marks in the GS Mains on 6th of October. Answer enrichment session on 8th of October. Answer essay writing on 12th. IR 15th, NCERT 19th, and prelims MCQ on 25th, right? So these are the various webinars. Our website is full of resources. So you can see our website. Let me show you the website. Website is full of resources, and you can really get a lot of free resources. If you click on the free resources, you will get so many free resources. You will get daily initiatives, free downloads, UPSC prelims questions, daily news prescription, static books, crux notes, optional strategy, mains articles, NCERT downloads, CSAT questions, Yojana, Kurukshetra, YouTube live videos, IGNU, NIOS books, UPSC previous year questions, right? So most of these features are already active. Couple of these are still in the process of being activated. So you can go through any of these features and you can download. You can basically go through all these things. And then on the home page, there are strategy blocks. So if you go to the beginner's space, you will find that we have a lot of articles and lot of blocks about various things. For example, beginner's strategy for IAS examination. So if you follow that, you can see the how to clear UPSC CSE by self-study and online, how to make a timetable, winning strategies, roadmap to success, complete list of UPSC books, NCERT book download. All of these important things are available on the website, and many more important features are coming.